Hey, what is up, guys? Welcome back to another video on Young Race Predictor, where today we are going to be doing the Spanish Grand Prix predictions, round 6, this season 2022. 5 races done, 2 race wins currently for the championship leader Charles Leclerc, but 3 race wins for the man who was in second, and he had recently won the Grand Prix that had taken place for the first time in Formula 1 history. And of course, I'm talking about the win given for the man who with number 1 on his name, Max Verstappen, won the Miami Grand Prix in the Hard Rock Stadium ahead of pole sitter Charles Leclerc, ahead of his teammate Carlos Sainz, who rounds off the top 3 on the podium. Although Ferrari had dominated the qualifying, it went to Red Bull on the race day and they got the most points. So that was how the Miami Grand Prix had turned out. Now we are returning back to Barcelona. Let's see how they are going to battle each other out, how they are going to race this time around for the Spanish Grand Prix. But let's look at my predictions first. So let's start off with the qualifying predictions from last all the way up to first. And those, according to me, who will be kicked out of Q1 are Lance Stroll, Yuki Tsunoda, Alexander Albon, Zhou Guan Yu and Nicholas Latifi. I haven't seen much of performances in Nicholas Latifi. I do hope he comes back into a situation where he manages to put his car into Q2. But I don't know, it'll be taking place to this weekend in Barcelona. So I think Latifi is going to be out of Q1 behind Zhou Guan Yu in the last row. So Zhou Guan Yu had been kicked out of qualifying last weekend in Miami in Q1 itself, and I think it is because of a traffic. So in case there can be a situation like that in Barcelona, so I don't think that maybe a chance for Zhou Guan Yu to make it ahead of P17, maybe he does have a chance of going into P14 and even after competing into Q2. But according to me, I think he is going to be out of Q1. Alexander Albon has been putting up an amazing performance so far this entire season and has given Williams about 4 points. He scored 4 points and the team also has scored 4 points. He has been an excellent driver so far this season on the grid with respect to Williams. So I think Albon is performing quite well, but he is not doing well in qualifying. He is in a situation where his maximum or minimum could be only P18, but his maximum could be only P15. So I think Albon will be out of qualifying. Tsunoda in P17, Lance Stroll out, just missing out in P16. So this is these are the people who will be kicked out of Q1. In Q2, those will be kicked out. Mick Schumacher in P15, again missing out a chance of a Q3 appearance. Esteban Ocon in P14 being qualified by Daniel Ricciardo. Sebastian Vettel and Fernando Alonso locking the 6th row. I do think Fernando Alonso and Sebastian Vettel have a huge chance of making it into Q3, but just missing out. Daniel Ricciardo surely for P13. Esteban Ocon does have a huge chance of making it into the top 10, but however, that may result in Pierre Gasly being kicked out, but I think Ocon will be P14. Schumacher is going to stay in P15. I do hope he does have a chance. In case if he does have a chance this weekend not to make it into Q3, I would be really relieved and I'll be really happy. But I think in my predictions he's going to be P15, Ocon P14, Ricciardo P13, Alonso and Vettel locking up the 6th row. Now looking at those from P5 all the way down to P10 are Lewis Hamilton ahead of Valtteri Bottas, both of them the former Mercedes teammates, locking up the 3rd row. Lando Norris and George Russell locking up the 4th row, and Kevin Magnussen and Pierre Gasly rounding off the top 10. So this is how I feel it will be. Bottas does have the ability in order to go at least ahead of one of the Mercedes. So I think it's going to be the chance that he'll go ahead of George Russell and finish in P6. Kevin Magnussen, not much of performance in qualifying. He performs at some instances of time, but I don't think the car is perfect during the first sessions or is not working out through towards the end of the sessions. I mean, if you do realize the fact, in Australia, he was kicked out in Q1 itself. In Imola, thanks to the rain and the crash which had taken place, Lando Norris and a red flag being pulled out, he was P4, but he was again kicked out in Q1 in Miami. So I don't think Magnussen may go ahead of P7, but I think his minimum would be P9, Pierre Gasly P10. George Russell may have a chance of going and replacing Lewis Hamilton, but at least one Mercedes has to be in the top 5. So I think that's going to be going to Lewis Hamilton, because after all, he has more wins and is one of the most experienced drivers on this circuit. So I think Hamilton will be P5, Bottas P6, Norris P7 and George Russell P8. The top 4 It's going to be a Red Bull second row lockout and a front row lockout once again for the Ferrari with Charles Leclerc on pole position. I have a huge feeling Leclerc is going to be on pole position for the Spanish Grand Prix. His teammate in his home race coming in second place in qualifying, I think he's going to be alongside his teammate and lock up the front row. It's going to be Leclerc ahead of Sainz. Verstappen needing a good start in case, even if I have a feeling like Leclerc or in at least one Ferrari is going to win. Verstappen, in case he needs a good start and finish in P2, he must start from a place like P3 or maybe like P4. I think P3 is the best, because if we do check out how it was in 2020, Bottas did not get a good start and Stroll all the way from P5 came to P3 in the first lap itself. So I think Verstappen has a huge chance now to make an overtake in lap number 1 if he starts from P3. In my predictions, he is P3, Perez is P4, it's a Ferrari front row lockout, Leclerc on pole, Sainz in P2. Well, the race result, according to me, the winner is a shock, and I think it's going to be given to Carlos Sainz. Sainz is going to be the winner of the Spanish Grand Prix of his home race. And in runner-up is his teammate, number 16, the championship leader, Charles Leclerc. It's going to be a Ferrari 1-2 once again this season. I think Carlos Sainz is going to win. Charles Leclerc in second. And in P3 is the man with number 1 on his name, Max Verstappen. I think he's going to come P3 in the Spanish Grand Prix. This is what is my race result. The fastest lap going to Max Verstappen in case he needs to battle enough with Charles Leclerc for the World Championship. I think he will have to take the fastest lap. Leclerc, it's more like 2021, you know. I mean, the person with 3 wins, which was Hamilton last year, was in P2 with the championship, but the one with 2 wins was actually leading. And in the 6th race, both of them retired, but the championship leader's teammate actually won the race. So I think it's going to turn out somewhat like that, but this time Leclerc and Verstappen will finish, but Leclerc will be ahead of Verstappen, making it a Ferrari 1-2 with his teammate Carlos Sainz winning his home race. And of course, with this, driver today will definitely go to Carlos Sainz. So this is my predictions. Hope you enjoy the video. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, share this with all the friends and all the F1 fans that you know. Please ask them to subscribe as well. Hit the notification bell so that you get notifications that I'll be uploading new videos on time. See you next time for the next video. Until then, next time, goodbye.